And welcome back to Sports Weekly on IEMG. You know, here we are in the month of June, and I think during a normal CIF season, this would be right about the same time that we'd have like the high school track and field state meet. But right now, we're still CIF Southern Section. We're going to the Southern Section meet right now. And Cajon High School has had a great season. Citrus Belt League champions on the boys' side. They can do it all. They've got the hurdler. They've got the sprinter. They got the field events. They cover all the bases. Two of their big stars this season, Seth Johnson, JeyQuan Smith, joining us here on Sports Weekly. In fact, Seth has qualified for the CIF Finals in three different events, the 100 hurdles, the high jump, the long jump, and JeyQuan, one of the fastest guys you're going to find in the Southern Section in the 100 and 200. So they're joining us here on the show. And guys, first off, congratulations on what the CBL season had for you guys, winning the Citrus Belt League crown. And JeyQuan, I'll start with you first. I mean, how important was it for you guys to go out there and beat some really good teams like Ucaipa and, you know, Redlands and Rev and whatnot to secure that Citrus Belt League title?
It meant the world to me because once my coach first told me that they had never won since they've been in the league, I was honestly surprised because, you know, the whole football thing, they won four consecutive years. So I'm like, okay, if they did that, I'm pretty sure their track team has won. But then he was like, oh, no, we lost to Ucaipa in consecutive years. So I was like, okay, so well, this is going to be Cajon's year. I'm going to make sure of that. It's going to be a team effort and everything.
It certainly was. And speaking of that team effort, JeyQuan, your teammate Seth Johnson also joined us here on the show. And Seth, winning CBL, JeyQuan just touched on it. You beat some really good teams to win that CBL championship. What did that mean to you?
It did mean a lot. Yeah, we raced them 2019 also and had pretty good shots, but unfortunately gave it to the Cajon boys. But this year we came back stronger than ever. We had a young team in 2019 and most of those guys are years now.
You know, Seth, if I asked you what's your top event, like what would you say you're the strongest in? Because you're pretty strong in a lot of different events, the hurdles, some of those field events as well. If I was going to ask you, though, what is your top event? What would you say that is?
I don't really know. It kind of depends on the day. Sometimes I have a great high jump day, and the other times I miss opening height and run real fast in the hurdles. It just really depends.
So let me ask you this then. What event do you think maybe going into the CIF Finals that you have your best shot of maybe, you know, getting on the podium, bringing home a medal? What do you think your best shot is?
I think 110 hurdles. Obviously, Upland has a really strong team, those four guys. Kai Blanks, the sophomore, he is real fast, ran 4:14.12, I believe, at prelims. But I'm not too far behind.
So, Seth, what is this season meant to you? Because I think, you know, coming out of COVID, we are all just hoping to have a season at all. And I know track was a purple sport, right, in the beginning. So you guys were pretty safe. But just the fact that, you know, here we are at a point where we're in the month of June and you've got a chance to win a CIF championship, you won a Citrus Belt League title, I'd imagine that feels pretty special in itself just to be at this point. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, I feel really blessed. A lot of our guys have been working out year-round with our head coach, Tracy.
All right, Seth, let me go back to JeyQuan for a second. And JeyQuan, when I think of, you know, track and field, we always look at those sprints to find out who's the fastest guy out there. And we're talking Southern Section. We're talking Division One. I mean, when you take that into consideration, That's the fastest of the fast, right? I mean, we're talking Division One, Southern California. These are the fastest guys around. And, oh, by the way, you're just a sophomore. I mean, are you kind of surprised at the success you've had, or were you kind of expecting this?
Honestly, I could say both. I expected me to do pretty well, but not as well as I'm doing right now. So it was, I guess I could say I'm blessed to be doing what I've been doing, because I've honestly surprised myself multiple times. And maybe even because I honestly hurt my ankle during this year and still managed to do good at all my events. So, hey.
How are you feeling right now? That's the big question, I guess.
I feel great. Ready for this Saturday.
All right, JeyQuan, we know you're a football star too, man. We saw you had the speed, the jets out there during the football season. So were you a football guy first and then you ran track, or did you run track and people said, hey, you're so fast, you should play football? Which one came first?
Oh, track most definitely came first. It's your track star all around. Football, I'm just good at football, but I'm great at track.
So when you look at the big picture, like, what are some of the goals that you have? Is it more so like, hey, I'd love to go to the Olympics and represent the United States in track and field? Or is it, hey, I'd like to be in the NFL?
Most definitely Olympics. But if I were to go to NFL, I would be pretty satisfied with it also. So
not too shabby, right? To maybe do both. Why not do both? Hey.
The more the merrier.
That's right. Seth, let me go back to you on this question because, you know, like JeyQuan said, Cajon has had some good track and field teams, but never before a Citrus Belt League championship. When you guys won CBL and you guys were posting great numbers, did that build some confidence in you guys when you went to the CIF prelims feeling like, okay, you know, we can hang with some of these big time Division I programs?
Yeah, I think so. This year, we've got just a phenomenal track team. We've won 10 out of the 15 events at CBL. And going into CIF, we are bringing 8 athletes, which is like the biggest field we've ever brought. I felt really confident that we could probably buy the top spot there.
And Seth, again, you know, if I asked you, like, what do you think your top event, you know, might be? And, you know, I know you qualified for the CIF finals in 3 different events, but, you know, which one do you think of all of those that you might spend more time at practice leading up to the finals? Or you're like, okay, I feel pretty confident about this event, but this one event, like, I'm really going to have to, you know, fine tune some things this week going into the finals.
I think the 110 hurdles also, since I do have a fairly good chance of winning it, I feel like there's a lot left in the tank. My technique is not where I ideally it should be. I think if I can get my rhythm faster, I'll run 2 times 10 seconds fast.
Well, guys, I really appreciate the time. Best of luck in the CIF Southern Section Finals. And it's already been a great season for you guys, but hopefully it continues and you have some hardware to show for it at the end of the year. So, Seth, JeyQuan, thank you so much, guys. Best of luck.
Thanks for having me.
All right, that's JeyQuan Smith and Seth Johnson joining us here on the Sports Weekly on IEMG. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back with more Sports Weekly.